Subby T, your favoriteest bro here. It's time to play a game based on a TV series that's based on a book from a guy with two middle initials. Because when one middle initial just isn't enough. Dude, I've thought about this stuff forever. Boobs, swords, dragons. If you talked about sword dragons or boob swords, everyone would laugh at you and call you that one weird kid. This guy releases it and they shower this guy in gold and bacon. It has to be those middle initials. Two is better than one. It makes you seem so official. Besides, like, everything is better with bacon, especially boob swords. Anyway, I love already that they kept the theme from the show. That's pretty legit. I actually do watch the show and I love it. It's kind of like my church on Sundays. I always make sure to attend. Problem with games based on really popular things like this is if the game isn't amazing, it gets shit on real quick. What's this? Autosave feature? No game does that. Options, mister. Is that DLC? Well, they're being adventurous. Yes, we want blood effects, because what's Game of Thrones without someone dying a horribly bloody death? Subtitles. See, they already had subtitles on. They were prepared. Graphics. Why do they always give you a graphics tab, but it never lets you tweak the graphics? It just lets you tweak the brightness? Just call it brightness and quit trying to be fancy about it. Trying to give us that illusion of control. It's not cool. Moderate difficulty, yes, sir. I just picked up my second middle initial, so now the game is asking me for permission to play itself. Told you, it's official.
Year 298. Westeros. Realm of the Seven Kingdoms. The world has changed. The ancient Targaryen line of kings had its fire extinguished after reigning over the Seven Kingdoms for many centuries. Robert Baratheon's rebellion unified most of the realm's great houses under a single banner, thus bringing about the fall of the Targaryens. Thus, 15 years ago, he acceded to the Iron Throne, becoming Lord of the Seven Kingdoms. Far from the Game of Thrones and political intrigues, far to the north, in the land where winter seems never to die, a border cuts the continent in two, the Wall. The Night's Watch has been its guardian for thousands of years, protecting the realm at all costs from wildling attacks and other menaces from beyond. The danger is constant, the cold is bitter, and death is sweet for those who fall. At times, even the bravest warriors give up and attempt to escape this white purgatory.
The Wall is like summer camp for assholes. It really is. What are you cooking up, bro?
Just some crossbow with a side of bleed out. I'm a vegetarian. Oh, really?
I knew that you were the one he'd send, Mars. Damned moment. It had to be you, huh?
It's over, old brother. All your attempts are in vain. You know I'll end up taking you to Castle Black, dead or alive.
Why not let me get away for old time's sake? After all, we're brothers.
You betrayed us by attempting to escape, my friend. My duty is to bring you back. You know there's only one way to leave the Night's Watch.
I'm sorry, Moise, you leave me no choice. Oh, shit.
You are Moors, a ranger in the Night's Watch, the military order charged with protecting and holding the immense wall separating the realm of the Seven Kingdoms from the Wildlands to the north. You are tormented by your past, the veteran and hero of Robert Baratheon's rebellion, which brought an end to the ancient order you betrayed your lord. You were forced to leave your family and homeland to go to the wall, far from the warmth and love of your wife and daughter, and into the arms of another man. Whoa! Oh, there's classes. A landed knight is well-versed in the art of combat, and he favors defense over attack. He wears heavy armor and bears a stout shield, which make him a determined and resilient fighter on the battlefield. Preferred equipment, swords, maces, short blades, and heavy armor. You're able to fight long battles, and this increases your chance of survival. Next. Is that the only guy it could be? Oh, no. Hedge Knight is an all-around fighter. Okay, so we got a one-handed knight, a two-handed knight, and a three-handed knight. I want to be Octopus Man, Lord of the Salty Realms. Oh, he's only got two hands. I was misinformed. I think I'm going to play the tank because I hate relying on, like, NPC tanks to do anything for me. Dead sword fight, bro. Strength increases damage inflicted on your enemies, the power of your crits, and physical resistance to hits. Okay, we're gonna put 8 in strength. What else does it do? Chili increases your attack speed, hit chance, and deflection. Luck increases your bonus loot, critical hit chance, and dodge. Endurance increases your health, and intelligence increases your energy recovery and skill learning. Increase the number of skill points you for weapon and armor gained at each level. Alright, we'll put one in each of these. I'll put one in agility. It affects my hit chance, which is probably extremely important. If you can't hit something, you can't kill it. Unless you use mind bullets. Self-defense. Unleashes a series of strikes. If your opponent attacks you, your third hit does 1.6 damage, so it's like a counterattack. Okay. What does this do? It looks like a baby. Is this a picture of a baby being dazed? Stun your opponent by slamming your shield into his face. Oh, that sounds fun. If your fighting spirit increases your nearby comrades, what does this do? Massive strike. Smash your opponent all around you. This ability is executed from your current position. Chance to inflict bleeding. Strike your opponent in an open wound. When 3 or more enemies are attacking you, my dodge and crit chance goes up. And shield strike. Okay, so that's the shield side. What's this? Taunt. Deride all opponents with your rapier wit to incite them to attack you. Okay. Resistance. Temporarily increase your damage. You are tougher and your enemies have greater difficulty in overpowering you. Show your true potential when surrounded by all members of your team, yourself included. Inflict more damage. Oh, so I'm like the leader of the party. Well, I want to be able to hurt somebody, so I'm going to daze him. And we'll get this one, so we have taunt. We only have 3 points? That sucks. Next. Do I want to use swords, maces, short blades? What are short blades? Like daggers? Yeah. Alright, we'll put that into there. And I guess we'll go with swords, right? With the strength and agility. What is this? Endurance and luck. Damage against heavy armor plus 15%. And what does swords do? Damage against light armor plus 15%. So I'll kill rogues and stuff faster. And this guy will kill warriors faster. Alright, we'll put that there. Yeah, I'll go all swords. I like swords, so. What is this? Balance found. Choice of character traits. Landed Knight Moors Westford. The number of strengths and weaknesses must be equal. You can choose up to 3 strengths. If your opponent is bleeding, you deal plus 15% damage to him. That's actually pretty good, isn't it? Acrobat. Your keen sense of balance allows you to deflect blows more skillfully. 2 extra skill points earned per level. Oh, so basically these are just little bonuses you can get. Obviously, I'm going to take the ones that help my guy the most. What helps me the most? Leech, if your opponent is bleeding, plus 15% damage. I do make people bleed. That might actually be good. Let's get that. What else can I get? I want that 2 extra skill points per level. Minus 7% damage for you and your allies. Deflection, minus 6%. That would make me worse at tanking. Wait, I should probably get this tanking ability instead. Deflect blows more skillfully. I'm not really in it for the damage. I'm gonna have to deal damage at some point. Oh, we're gonna be here all day. I have a collapsed lung. That's cool. All these are only worth 1. What's grayscale? That would just cancel each other out. Clumsy, asthmatic. Attack speed because I have the gout. Energy recovery doesn't sound like anything. I don't even know how the game mechanics work. That's why this is so hard. I don't even know how the game works. I've never played it. How does the game freaking work? They got me making choices. I don't even know how the game works. I don't even know if 2 extra skill points per level even matters. It probably doesn't. Witless? So I can be dumb? Like I said, I don't know how the game works. This is tough. Do I have to choose 3 strengths? Where's that one where I'm allergic to poison? There we go. Okay. Yeah, sure. I don't even know how the game works. They got me choosing all these buffs and debuffs to my character. I don't even know how the game works. So the dog didn't bite him? Did the dog and him have like a fist fight or something that he's got a busted eye?
Castle Black. Nothing's changed since the day we arrived. 15 years. Remember, Morris? We were so strong back then. At the time, I really believed in the mission of the Night's Watch, you know?
You've changed, old brother. I never thought you would betray us.
Aye, well... You've always had a knack for choosing friends. One night here, and you'd already bashed in 3 of our brother's skulls.
I wasn't the only one there, if I remember rightly.
That's me. I never think of the consequences. All I do is give.
Look at this, boys. Mors finally brought back that worm, Gorol. Well done. Some men bet against you, but I wagered you'd make it. It must have been quite a hunt.
Gorol knows how to cover his tracks and isn't half bad with the sword.
I've known you for 15 years, but I still had just a shred of hope that I'd give you and your damn dog the slip. I would have hated getting caught by a little shit like our friend here.
Hold your tongue, deserter.
That's not what your mother said last night.
I'll teach you about respect, dog!
Enough! I forbid you to touch him. You would not have had the slightest chance against him, blade in hand. Tell me, where is Mormont?
The Lord Commander is in front of the Commander's keep with the new recruits. They've just sworn their oaths.
So they are finally sworn brothers of the Night's Watch. Fools. Now you can teach them a little lesson. Right, Mors?
Mors, you've brought this traitor back. I knew I could count on you.
I did what I had to, Lord Commander.
Your modesty does you honor. Recruits, listen to me. Mors here is our best tracker. Now that you are sworn brothers of the Night's Watch, he will mold you into rangers. He has just returned from a very delicate mission, tracking down Gorals, who took the cowardly route and deserted. In the name of the Night's Watch, I thank you, Mors. I know how hard it must have been for you to hunt down a friend.
I swore an oath to the Watch. If we go back on our word and our mission, then we are nothing.
If only all my men spoke like that.
Speaking of new brothers, I see only four of them. Where is the fifth?
Someone attacked him last night. He's been looked after by Maester Aemon as we speak. One of our brothers has broken his vows in the most sordid manner. That traitor then beat the poor boy and left him in the snow, more dead and alive.
Damn it. I swear I'll skin the culprit alive.
Alas, we do not know if the boy will recognize his assailant, or even if he is to survive.
Too bad. The brat certainly was a pretty boy, soft as a virgin. What a pity I never managed to corner him.
True to your reputation, Gorold, eh?
Boy lover!
You know me, always trying to get a laugh.
Silence, traitor. Each time I pass judgment on a deserter, I feel the bitterness of failure. It is my duty, as Lord Commander of the Night's Watch, to make true brothers of you. This morning, you were strangers. Now, you have all sworn to honor our oath. Some come to us as knights, carrying out their duties, and some as criminals, forced to choose between the noose and the wall. Once you take the black, your past is dead. You must wash away your former loyalties, forget your family and friends. They cease to exist. Such is the strength of our oath. No wife, no children, no lands. All that matters is defending the wall and the realm. We are your only home. We are your duty. We are your new family, the only one that matters now. More than 8,000 years ago, humanity itself was nearly lost during the Long Night. Our predecessors then built the wall that you see behind us. This massive wall of ice is 700 feet high and divides the continent in half. It protects the realm of the Seven Kingdoms from threats beyond the wall. Defending it is our purpose, our duty. The Night's Watch has unfailingly carried out this mission for centuries, generation after generation. Wildlings, cold, wind, and dishonor. Those are your enemies, even in the midst of a summer such as this one. We have all taken our vows before the gods, whichever gods they are. If you betray your brothers, if you break this sacred oath, throughout the Seven Kingdoms of Westeros, you will be met with one punishment. Death.